الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أرسلناك إلا كافة للناس بشيرا ونذيرا My brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I deem it an honor and privilege for me to be in your midst and to discuss some Islamic problems which the Muslim Ummah is facing in this part of the world. I would like to apologize that since I have very rare opportunities to speak in English, it seemed to be rather difficult to express myself fluently in this language, and you may have to tolerate my broken expression, but I was asked by my brothers that the medium of discussion should necessarily be English, particularly in this khutbah. So I try my best to express myself, and I believe that the love, the Islamic love we have in our heart needs no eloquence or frequency, and sometimes the broken words can convey what the eloquent speeches cannot. So the topic which I have just been given to speak on is the way of practicing Islam in America different from the way of practicing it in other parts of the world? This is the question framed before me, and I was asked to speak on it. In this respect, I have just recited a verse of the Holy Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, addressing the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to His beloved Holy Prophet that we have sent you to all the human beings. We have sent to you as a bearer of glad tidings to the humanity and as a water. But we have sent to you to all the human beings on this globe, on this earth. Previously, the prophets were being sent to a particular nation only. Sayyidina Musa alayhi wasalam was sent to the children of Israel, to Bani Israel. Sayyidina Isa alayhi wasalam was also sent to the children of Israel. And many other prophets which were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were sent to a particular nation, a particular tribe, or a particular part of the world. But the holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the last prophet, was sent to all the human beings. And this holy verse says that Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been sent down for all the human beings found on the face of the earth. His messengerhood, his prophethood is not restricted to Arabia only. He is as good a messenger in North America as he is in Saudi Arabia. So his message, his teachings, his instructions, all instructions are encompassing all the human beings found on the earth. So the teachings and instructions given by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, either through Holy Quran or through his Sunnah, govern all the circumstances faced by the Muslims all over the world. So one cannot say that Islam in Asia is different from Islam in Africa, or Islam in Africa is different from Islam in America or Europe. Islam is the same. What is Islam? Islam is the guideline provided by the Holy Quran and Sunnah. The Holy Quran is one. The Sunnah of the Holy Prophet is one. There is no discrimination in the Holy Quran and in the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet. But at the same time, since Islam has come to guide the humanity for all times to come, and for all people of different areas of the world, Islam itself has given us such teachings or such instructions which can be practiced throughout the world without any restriction. As you all know, that Islam is not a religion like Christianity or a Jewish religion. It does not confine its teachings to the ritual, to the rituals only. It is actually a code of life. Its teachings and instructions relate to the economic, to the social, to the political affairs of the Ummah. Islam does not teach us that you are Muslim when you are in the mosque only. It says that you are Muslim when you are in the mosque, you are Muslim when you are in the market, you are Muslim when you are at your home, you are Muslim when you are working on your job. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu udkhulu fis-silmi kaffah. O those who believe, enter Islam, whole of you. And Islam is not some ritual performed in the holy mosque only. Islam is a set of instructions, is a set of teachings which cover our socio-political, socio-economic life also. So when we are working on our jobs, when we are at our homes, the Holy Quran and Sunnah of the Holy Prophet ﷺ have given us clear instructions. And those instructions and those teachings are not so difficult to practice on them. Whenever a Muslim studies the Holy Quran and studies the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet ﷺ, he will find that in each sphere of life there is a set of instructions. But there is a very wide area which has been left over by the Holy Quran and Sunnah as mubah, as permissible. As in that wide area, you can choose whatever you want. But there are only some obligations. For example, five prayers and the prohibition of some acts. These obligations and prohibitions, which is normally said al-awamir wa nawahi. Al-awamir, obligation. Nawahi, injunction or prohibition. these within the framework of these awamir and nawahi, within the framework of this these obligations and prohibitions, one is under an obligation to follow all these injunctions, whether no matter he is in America or if he is in Pakistan or in Saudi Arabia. So if, for example, wine is prohibited, that means that it is prohibited for all parts of the world. One cannot say that it is prohibited in Saudi Arabia and is not prohibited in North America. If pork is prohibited, it is prohibited for all the world. One cannot say that it is prohibited in Saudi Arabia or in Pakistan and it is not prohibited in North America. So all the prohibitions, all the obligations are for all the Muslims who follow the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who declared to be Muslims, who professed the kalima of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So all the percepts are the same for all the world. Now, but there are some concessions given by the Sharia in some matters, not for a particular area or for a particular nation, but subject to certain conditions laid down by the Holy Quran and Sunnah. Those concessions are available for Pakistanis, for Saudi Arabians, for Americans also. So one cannot discriminate between the Muslims of America and Muslims of other parts of the world. Islam is the same, the Holy Quran is the same, the teachings of the Holy Prophet or Sunnah of the Holy Prophet is the same. But within that framework, there is a wide area of mubaha where one can choose a way according to his own experience, according to his own needs, according to his own taste. For example, Islam did not lay down a particular type of meal to eat, subject to certain prohibitions. Islam has said that you can't eat pork. Islam has said that you can't eat a meat which is not slaughtered in the Islamic way. But subject to these conditions, Islam has not laid down a particular type of meal which you can eat. Subject to these conditions, whatever meal you like, you can eat, whether in North America or whether in Pakistan. So the question that the way of practicing Islam in America, this way of practicing Islam in America is the same as it is in other parts of the world, or it is some different way, the answer to this question is very simple, that there is no discrimination according to the areas or geographical boundaries. Islam is the same. Islam is the set of instructions laid down by the Holy Quran and Sunnah for all times to come, for all the human beings found on the earth. But the main thing is to understand Islam. What is Islam? What Islam does require from a Muslim? Whether I can be a Muslim by pronouncing the kalima of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah only, without believing that there is only one God, without believing that the teachings of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are true and we are under the obligation to obey them, without following any guidance provided by the Holy Quran and Sunnah, whether then I will be Muslim by entering my name in the register of Muslims only. That is not the requirement of Islam. As I have cited to you, the work of the Holy Quran which says, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu udkhulu bisilmi kaffah. O those who believe, enter Islam wholeheartedly. So, this work addresses the Muslims, where he says, O those who believe. It presumes that the addressee has believed. But despite all this, the verse says, enter Islam. It means that entering Islam is something different from where they believe. And entering Islam cannot be completed unless one submits himself to the injunctions provided by the Holy Quran and Sunnah. Islam actually means in Arabic language, when you, if you consult any Arabic dictionary, you will find that Islam means submission, total submission. This is its literal meaning in according to the Arabic dictionary. Al-Islam, total submission. So, when Allah says that all those who believe, enter Islam, all of you, it means that a Muslim cannot be a true Muslim until he submits totally to the precept of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If he says, I am a believer, I am a Muslim, but I don't believe in such prohibition or in such instruction given by the Holy Quran and Sunnah, he is not a true Muslim because he has not submitted himself to the teachings of the Holy Quran and Sunnah. So the very first requirement for a Muslim is total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sayyiduna Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as you all know, that he was ordered to slaughter his own child, Ismail alayhi wa sallam. He received this command by Allah, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he never argued before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the reason? Why you are ordering me to slaughter my son? I have got this son after a long time. And what is the offense committed by this son that you are ordering me to slaughter him? Nobody can offer any reasonable explanation or any reason for slaughtering one's own son. But when he received the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he did not question it. It's reasoning. It's just he merely followed it. And he asked his son also, and asked him, Inni ara ati abbahuka fil manami fanzur ma ta tara. I have been ordered in my dream that I should slaughter you. What is your opinion? What do you think about it? Ismail answered, Ya abati fa'al ma tu'mar. My father, please do what you have been ordered to do. Inni satajiduni inshallah wa sabi. You will find me among the patients. I have not cried. I have not stopped you from slaughtering myself. This was the answer of his son. And accordingly, Sayyidina Ibrahim Khalil alayhi wa sallam laid his son down and started slaughtering him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when refers to this event, this historic event, he says in the surah of Saffat, he says, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا. When both of them, father and son, when both of them submitted themselves. At this exact occasion, the word used by the Holy Quran and Sunnah is aslama. When they entered Islam, when they submitted themselves, this denotes that Islam actually means total submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam without questioning the reason of the command. This is Islam. So, this Islam should be followed in word and in word and spirit. In all parts of the world, there is no discrimination. There is no Holy Quran has nowhere said that the way of practicing it in a part is different from the way of practicing in another part. So this is the requirement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Holy Quran and Sunnah from us all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand Islam as it is understand and to understand the Islamic teachings in its total spirit and to follow it and be a practicing Muslim as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be. And in the last, thank you all. I am grateful for your patient hearing, and I also request all of you that you should not forget me and all the Muslim Ummah from your du'as, and we all should pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he may give us tawfiq to be true Muslims according to his own will and pleasure. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alam wa aqru da'wah and thank you Allah wa ta'ala. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان سيدنا وسندنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله ارسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعه صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى اله واصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ايها الذين امنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافه ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان انه لكم عدو مبين وقال الله تبارك وتعالى يا ايها الناس اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم اعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما انا عرضنا الامانه على السماوات والارض والجبال فابين ان يحملنها واشفقن منها وحملها الانسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا ليعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لامرئ ما نوى فمن كان هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته إلى دنيا يطيبها بامرأته ينجحها فهجرت هجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الا ويحن نفسا لمن تموت حتى تستكمل رزقها فاجملوا في الصلم وتوكلوا عليه اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين الحمد لله احمده واستعينه واستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان سيدنا وسندنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله ارسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعه من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعصهما فانه لا يضر الا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وازواجه وذريته قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أهم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وأقواهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين اللهم اغفر للعباس وملكه مغفرة ظاهرة لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي ومن أحبهم فبحبه أحبهم ومن أبغضهم فببغضه أبغضهم وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واذكروا لي ولا تكفرون الله الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ولا تحسبن الله غافلا عما يعمل الظالمون إنما يؤخرهم ليوم تشخص فيه الأبصار مهطعين مقنعي رؤوسهم لا يرتد إليهم طرفهم وأفئدتهم هواء وأنذر الناس يوم يأتيهم العذاب فيقول الذين ظلموا ربنا أبصرنا ربنا أبصرنا إلى أجل قريب نجب دعوتك ونتبع الرسل أولم تكونوا أقسمتم من قبل ما لكم من زوال وسكنتم في مساكن الذين ظلموا أنفسهم وتبين لكم كيف فعلنا بهم وضربنا لكم الأمثال وقد مكروا مكرهم عند الله مكرهم وإن كان مكرهم لتزول منه الجبال الله